Assalomu alaykum, hurmatli 22A18 guruhi talabalari. Bugun sizlar bilan bullying mavzusida ingliz tili fanidan ochiq darsimizni o'tkazamiz. Good afternoon, dear students. Today we have the open classes, English classes on theme bullying. First of all, we must identify the meaning of the word of bullying. What is bullying? Bullying is an ongoing physical or verbal mistreatment where there is an imbalance of power and the victim is exposed repeatedly to negative actions on the part of one or more other students. Now, the average bullying behavior lasts only 37 seconds. Teachers notice and intervene in only one out of 25 episodes. It occurs at least two or three times per month. Now, bullying can be the direct and the face-to-face bullying. Now, they are the types of bullying. Now, the first one is a direct or face-to-face bullying. And we can divide the face-to-face bullying into three groups. The first one is a verbal, and second one is psychological, and third one is the physical bullying. And next type of the bullying is the indirect bullying. Now, it's the meaning of behind someone's back. For example, exclusion, gossip, or relational aggression. Now, what's bullying? It involves a power imbalance between bully and victim. Number, size, status, role, culture and ethnicity. Now, what is the characteristics of bully? Now, there are given some characteristics of bully. For example, high self-esteem, may be popular, more likely to engage in other problem behaviors later in life, such as criminal activity or alcohol or other drug abuse. And what is the characteristics of victims? Now, there are two characteristics of victims. Now, the first one is a passive and the second one is a proactive. Now, bullying is very similar with violence. Violence is any mean word, look, sign, or act that hurts a person's body, feelings, or things. Demak, qadrli o'quvchilar, bullying so'zini o'zbek tiliga qo'pollik yoki bo'lmasam ataylab qilingan tajovuzkorlik, kimgadir qaysidir maqsadlarda so'z yoki jismoniy harakatlar bilan shikast yetkazishga aytiladi. Demak, bullyingni turli xil ko'rinishlari yoki turlari bilan biz tanishib chiqdik. U to'g'ridan-to'g'ri yoki bo'lmasam biror bir narsalar orqali, ya'ni vositalar orqali amalga oshirilishi mumkin ekan. Assalomu alaykum, hurmatli 9-18 guruhi talabalari. Bugun sizlar bilan ingliz tili fanidan telecommunications mavzusida ochiq darsimizni o'tkazamiz. Good afternoon, dear students. Today we have the open class on theme telecommunication in English. Now let's begin our lesson. First of all, I want to talk about some information, the history of the telecommunication devices. For example, telephone. Now, who invented the first telephone? Did you know what there are more telephones in the world than there are people? Now it's amazing. Yes, cell phones alone add up to more than 6 billion. There are over 7 billion people in the world. It's hard to imagine a world without a telephone and the person we have to thank for the telephone is Alexander Graham Bell, who invented it in 1876. So, the telephone was invented by Alexander Graham Bell. Now, Alexander was born on March the 3rd, 1847 in Edinburgh, Scotland. As a young boy, he was very talented in music, poetry, and art. And when he was only 12 years old, he began inventing things. Also, when he was 12, his mother began to lose her hearing and was later to become completely deaf. This greatly affected Alexander, who became very interested in the scientific study of sound and the human voice. So the motivation was the mother of Alexander Graham for inventing the telephones. In 1870, at the age of 23, Alexander moved to Canada with his parents, where they bought a farm in the province of Ontario. It was there that he built a small workshop to continue his experiments in sound in 1871. Alexander moved to Boston in the United States to teach deaf students, people who couldn't hear, now how to communicate. One of his students was Helen Keller, who was unable to see, hear, or speak. Starting from 1873, he began to teach less and focus his energy on experiments with sound. On March 10, 1876, while working on his invention, Mr. Bell spoke the first words ever into telephone. "Mr. Watson, come here. I want to see you." When he had a small accident in his laboratory. The first telephone emission that was able to carry the human voice over long distance had been invented. By 1886, over 150 million people in the United States owned one, and our world will never be the same again. Alexander Graham Bell died in Canada in 1922. And now, dear student, they are given some exercise, the text as we had above, and I will now deliver this for you, and you must do this exercise, and please send me when